How's that? Now, we're not done yet. Right? We're not done yet. They haven't. Completely lost in here. I have no idea how to get out of this IKEA. Completely lost. Remember this? Let there be light. Oh yeah, baby, there it is. Oh, butter my bread. And you can stand right in the middle of the studio. You go in after them. Go! How's that? Now, we're not done yet. Right, we're not done yet. They haven't. Our YouTube family hasn't seen it yet. Isn't this cool? He's totally helping.
This is amazing.
Isn't it cool? Boom, back to the future. Or into the future. Into the future. Okay, here we go. A little countdown. 3, 2, 1, and welcome to the new studio. There it is. Oh my goodness, everybody. It's just crazy. Like, I used to have my lawnmower in here, my weed eater, my saws. I still have some saws in here, but here's the shelving. Here's the backdrop. Of course, a little neon green lighting to get a little pizzazz going in here.
That's right. Progress, progress, progress. Here in the studio, staying organized. I'm looking at the pile of shoes, and a couple people have pointed out on Strava and down in the comments, Seth, I think you need to get a little grip on your shoe situation. So that's our mission right now. There we go. So I'm trying my best to get everything off the ground here in the studio because from last winter, I remember every time it snows and the snow is trying to melt off the roof through the gutters, for some reason, a little bit of water backs up and ends up here in the studio, the AKA the shed. So anyway, that's what I'm doing today. Part of the strategy is keep everything off the ground so it doesn't get wet through the winter months. And oh man, always something, right? Always something. One second. Got the broom. Definitely need to sweep out in here. All right, hold on one sec. Okay, I'm feeling real good, everybody. So we got one of the shelves up right here. It's secure to the wall. And I don't have these little plastic things to hold the shoes up right now, so I'm not gonna put the shoes up, and I still need to put lights shining down on the shoes. Also, I have the second shelf, it's outside. I didn't assemble it yet because I forgot the sprinkler box. I think I have a shot of the sprinkler box is in the way, and I'm not gonna move the sprinkler box quite yet, probably once I shut down the sprinklers for the winter. So feeling good, and yes, don't you worry, I do have a game plan for the mountain of shoes behind me. And of course, we've got a heater here for the winter, a space heater. So it is in the evening time when I'm out here filming, it is starting to cool off, but I do have a space heater. We're gonna make it. You just gotta be flexible in this world, right? Patience and flexibility is the key. Sorry about that. The battery died. My bad, my bad. I'm back. So the Houston Half Marathon was canceled about 7 days ago. And so I have, it's hard, everybody. You gotta put in the time, the research to find the races that fit your niche. And I talked about that upper right-hand corner, how to find your niche in running, but also that fits your schedule, of course, but also fits your goals for the race. You know, are you going for a PR? Are you going for just a shakeout, kind of a rust buster? So for me, leading into 2021, and yes, I will do some rust buster races here in Denver before going to this location. I'll tell you in 1 second, in preparation for this peak race. Okay, so I'm looking for, so thank you for all your ideas that were shared on the vlog 2 days ago. But some of the races were at elevation, so I'm looking to race fast. So therefore, you want sea level, you want a flat course, and you want competition. Those are my three criterias for running as fast as possible. Sea level, flat course, and competition. I don't want to win the race. I don't want to lead the race. I want to either be chasing guys or preferably right in a pack of guys, okay? So those are my criteria as I break it down. Also, or as I make a decision and discern for my peak race in 2021. But winter is coming. It helps so much. For all the new racers, all the new runners out there, it's harder to train in the winter. It's freezing out, and maybe you live in a warm location, that's great, but for everybody that doesn't, and you know, maybe you live in, you know, Maine, or maybe you live in Minnesota or Norway or whatever it is, and you're new to running, just so you know, I personally have found it helps so much to have a race to train for in the winter time, let's say January, February, or March, in order to keep that motivation up to help you, yes, turn that doorknob and get out the door through those, yes, I'll say dark winter months. And speaking of competition, this was last year's results. So this is right in my PR in the half marathon, which I set in a marathon race, is 106 high. So here are the top five or six runners from 2000. And I guess it would have been 2020. These were the winners for the elite field at this particular half marathon. It's perfect, it's amazing. This is exactly the type of competition I'm looking for, right in that, let's say, 103 to 106 range for me, okay? So that's the type of group that I wanna be packing up with, yes, at the 2021 Miami Half Marathon. We're coming for you, Florida. So that is the next peak race for me that I'm registered for. Now, I do have, because I'm fully aware, things are up in the air completely for all of us, and that's why I have backups to the backups. So I have two other races. I'm not gonna share where yet, but two other races that if Miami, for some reason, is canceled or postponed, two other races that I could pivot to moving forward, okay? So there you go. If you live in the greater Miami area, I'm coming for you January 31st, 2021. Cannot wait. The competition is there. It's sea level. And yes, it's basically a very flat course. There's a couple bridges that you cross over, but compared to the bridges, let's say in New York City, they're nothing. So I'm excited. Miami, Florida. Now, as far as my race goals for Miami, and just so you know, it's the Miami Half Marathon that is sponsored by Lifetime, okay? So if you're interested in this race, in fact, if I remember, I'll try to link to it down below in the description, and I will reveal to you my goal times for the race, my training plan for the race, all in future vlogs, probably in the next couple of weeks as we move toward the training block starting October 19th. That's what it was. I knew there was something else I wanted to share, is that this is going to be a 15-week training block, and that first week is just going to be baby stuff, like literally 3 mile jog, 2 mile walks, 3 mile, just like getting the legs. After 2 weeks off, I don't want to rush back into it. So 15 weeks is going to be perfect, but it's really going to be a 14-week training block for this half marathon. So I'm excited. Okay, one more point before the question of the day is that if you've made it this far in the vlog, congratulations, because I'm giving away, that's right, a brand new running backpack from Mizuno. Running City USA, the Atlanta Track Club, sent me this, and I just haven't used it, and I don't want it to sit out here in the studio for too long. I found this in the cleaning out today. So there you go, and one person is gonna win this backpack, is that, and by the way, it has a location inside the backpack just for your running shoes to keep them separate from all your other running gear. It also has this hook. So this is like a perfect backpack for a post-race. Like if you're running a marathon and you have a bag check, perfect backpack. for that. So here you go. Twitter is the way you're going to win this. Here's my Twitter handle. The first person to tag me and retweet, so you got to go to my profile, find this backpack picture on my profile, retweet it. The first person to do that will win this backpack. All right, so, and I'm probably going to be asleep when this happens because this publishes at 5 a.m. So I will let you know if you were the first to retweet this. All right, everyone, thanks for watching. Thanks for being here. Question of the day: have you registered for your 2021 races yet, or are you waiting right now? The other part was, are you buying insurance for your races? That's a newer option these days. Maybe they've been doing that a long time, I don't know, where you can basically pay like an extra 10 bucks or 15 bucks and you're guaranteed to get all your money back. So anyway, I'm just curious to hear your strategy for registering for races in 2021, or maybe you're just waiting, and that's fine too. There's no right answer here. I'm just curious to hear what you all are up to with respect to goals down the line. I think that's it, everybody. We're gonna toss it back to, I thought of one earlier. Oh yeah, we'll toss it back to the first renovation of the studio about 7 or 8 months ago. Studio renovation right here. Studio renovation right here. All right, everyone, see beauty. Work hard and love each other. See you tomorrow.